In this screencast, we're going to perform sample material balance calculations on a simple one-stage batch still. In our still, we have 50 moles of an ethanol water mixture, and at the beginning of the distillation process, the head temperature is recorded, or the vapor temperature is recorded, and that's determined to be 84 degrees C. The still is going to be run until the head temperature is 89 C, and what we're trying to determine are both the total amount of distillate collected and also the composition of distillate and waste products. In these calculations, capital W is going to indicate the total number of moles of waste in the pot still, or the liquid that is in the pot still at any given time. X sub W is the instantaneous composition of that liquid in the still. And then we have D being the amount of distillate that's produced, and also X sub D is the composition of the distillate. And X sub D, and for the case of these calculations, is an instantaneous composition. In a batch still operation, the compositions of both the distillate product and the composition in the pot still at any given time is going to be varying. So what we need is some relationship that we can use for the material balances in that system over time. And that relationship is the Rayleigh equation shown here on the right. The Rayleigh equation simply relates the amount of moles of liquid in the still at the beginning time point to the amount of moles in the still at the end of the batch still operation, and relates that to the integral of this term here, which relates the instantaneous composition of the distillate and the instantaneous composition of what's in the still, that liquid phase itself. We integrate this term on the right-hand side with respect to the composition of the liquid inside the still at any given time, and we integrate over the range from the final composition to the initial composition. Now, this is a general form of the Rayleigh equation relating the liquid composition to the distillate composition. Here, we have a special case where we actually have the distillate actually being in equilibrium with the liquid in the pot still at any given time, because this whole process is driven by vapor-liquid equilibrium. So in this special case, we can replace the composition of the distillate with a composition of the vapor phase when we're dealing with vapor-liquid equilibrium. We can also replace the composition of the liquid in the pot still at any given time with an instantaneous composition associated with a liquid phase. And then these X and Y compositions are related through vapor-liquid equilibrium. We changed our limits of integration to correspond to taking the integral with respect to the liquid composition, and now we're integrating from the final liquid composition to the original liquid composition, much in the same way we had before for the original Rayleigh equation. Now we have an expression we can solve for the final number of moles of liquid in the still when we're done running the still. Our plan for solving this equation is going to be to get the XY data, or the vapor-liquid equilibrium data, for this particular ethanol water system, do the numerical integration on the right-hand side of this system, and then use this to solve for that final amount of moles in the still. So as a first step, we went to Perry's handbook and pulled out XY data, or vapor-liquid equilibrium data, for this ethanol water system, and we've plotted it here. You'll also note that I have the temperature data associated with this VLE data. This is going to allow us to determine the limits of integration for the liquid composition when we start the system and the still head temperature is 84 degrees C. We can see that the composition of the liquid is approximately 17%. Then as we run that still, the temperature is going to increase until we finally get to a point where we have the temperature of the still approximately 89 degrees. And at that point, the composition of the liquid phase is now going to be only 7% ethanol. Now for our calculations using the Rayleigh equation, we know we're doing an integration with respect to that liquid composition. So the important numbers we need to pay attention to now are the 17% composition of the liquid phase when we start that pot still operation, and the 7% composition of the liquid phase at the end of the system. So now that we have the vapor-liquid equilibrium data to do the numerical integration on the right-hand side, all that's left for us to do is actually execute that numerical integration. There are several options to choose from with varying degrees of accuracy associated with each. Popular choices include the Simpson's rule, which fits the data that you have to a curve and solves for the area under the curve and then adds and sums those areas up. The trapezoidal rule fits your data as a series of trapezoids and sums up those trapezoids to get the integration. And finally, we have the right-hand rule, which fits your data curve to a series of rectangles and sums up those rectangles to determine the area under the curve. While the right-hand rule has the highest amount of error associated with approximating that integral, we're going to use it here just for the sake of simplicity. So our general approach is to find a value for dx divided by y minus x, and then sum up those values to determine the overall integral value. When we return to our spreadsheet, you see I've added a column here for dx, and that column has values associated with the difference in the x compositions. So in this particular case, we're taking the difference between this x composition and the one that preceded it. Now to calculate the full term of dx divided by y minus x, I've taken our calculated value for dx at this particular instant and divided that by y, which is the vapor phase composition. Here it's 0.17, minus the liquid phase composition, and here it's 0.019. And now to approximate the integral, we just need to add up the sections of this dx divided by y minus x that lie between our starting point and our ending point, indicated here. And when we sum those up, we get an approximated value for that integral. Now when we return to the Rayleigh equation, we can see that we can substitute in for that integral our value for the sum of 0.027, and also for the starting amount of material in the still, we can insert 50 mole from our original problem statement. Now it's a simple matter of solving the equation to determine the final number of moles in the pot still when we're finished with our operation is going to be 38 moles. To determine the total number of moles of distillate that have generated, we just simply have to do a material balance on the whole process, where we take the number of moles that entered the system in the pot still, being the initial amounts of material we added to the still at the beginning, and that's going to be what ended up in the still at the end of the distillation operation, and also what exited the still in the form of distillate. When we substitute in the values that we know for what was in the still as liquid at the beginning of the batch still operation and at the end of the batch still operation, we can determine that 12 moles left the system in the form of distillate. To get the composition of the distillate that exited the top of the still, all we have to do is a total ethanol balance of what started in the system, what ended inside that pot still, and what exited the pot still in terms of distillate. When we plug in the values we've previously determined in terms of what started in the still, the composition that started from the still, and we determine that from just our TXY diagram, what remains in the still based on the Rayleigh equation, the final composition of what's in the still based on the TXY diagram, and then the amount of distillate that left based on our material balances, all that's left to find is the composition of the distillate on average. Run those numbers and we determine that we have approximately 46% ethanol in that distillate product. If we want to check to see if this composition makes any sense according to what we have in our system, all we have to do is go back and look at the TXY diagram and see what the composition of the distillate should have been from the start of the distillate operation and to the end of that batch still operation. When we started, we could see the vapor in the system was approximately 51% ethanol. And then when we ran that system all the way to the end, we see the composition was approximately 39% ethanol. So our composition of 46% ethanol lies between those two bounds and is a reasonable number to have as an answer. Now, as far as the last part of the problem of determining the composition of the waste product, for that we just need to see what the composition of the liquid was at the end of the distillation operation. And there we could have read that directly off the TXY diagram and seen the composition at the end was only approximately 7% ethanol.